News at 5, a detective who killed an unarmed black man in a controversial shooting will be back at work on Monday. The Fort Myers police detective shot Christopher Jordan after being told he had a gun. He didn't. Tonight, black leaders are saying this is a huge problem, and the mayor is backing the decision to call the shooting justified. WEEK News reporter Liz Biro has more on both sides of what happened here.
That single shot fired from Detective James Michella's gun took 58-year-old Christopher Jordan's life.
911, what's your emergency?
The chaos started with a 911 call from the victim's sister.
In the house, don't threaten me with his gun.
On the scene, Cynthia Jordan doubled down, told Fort Myers police officers and detectives the same thing.
Did he present a firearm and point it towards you?
Said it was a 45 Magnum, and her brother was mollied out. Cynthia's allegations are what State Attorney Amira Fox and Mayor Kevin Anderson say created the tension.
Mr. Jordan and family members created that atmosphere of, yes, this is a dangerous situation.
And that danger escalated when Detective James Michella said Jordan made movements consistent with loading a handgun and pointed a black handgun at the direction of officers who were not behind cover. But no gun was found, not when Florida Department of Law Enforcement searched the home shortly after midnight.
Since there was no gun, what did you see?
Sarah Wilson is an advocate for the Jordan family, got close with them while working with the NAACP.
If you have bad apples within your department who now know that they can just say, ooh, you know, I thought I saw a gun, that makes me worry.
Worry it sets a dangerous precedent where a police officer doesn't need to be as careful and can use what they think they saw as justification for using deadly force. Mayor Kevin Anderson, a former Fort Myers cop himself, doesn't see it that way.
I have complete confidence that State Attorney Amira Fox did a thorough investigation. Her team did a thorough investigation, and they did not see where the actions of the police officer was not justified.
So what happens now? The local NAACP and Christopher Jordan's brother plan to get the Department of Justice or the FBI involved, but what are the chances the Fed actually takes the case and files charges against the detective? Well, that's Amy Gallo's story, all new at 6. I'm live in downtown Fort Myers, Liz Biro, WINK News.